That's a beautiful area. Canberra, huh? Canberra sandwich. It's 7 degrees now here. In the north, it is about 7, 8.
There's a little flock of tiny seagulls, look, and you're missing them.
Oh, I see. They're hanging around there. They know what they're after. Okay, this is Camber Sand Beach in the East Sussex. It's one of the most beautiful beaches I've seen. The only problem here is that there is so much dogs here. You cannot with a you know, be relaxed, sitting somewhere, putting a towel or somewhere, sit. They will come and just piss on you. Let me give you a good view of this beautiful land, part of the UK, England. These pictures are legendary. One of the most beautiful scenic places I've seen. Under the water, this is very strange. It's made of this, covered in sand, as if kind of pastry. You'd roll it in the pistachio or nuts. But it's made of something else, the actual material. Quite tiny. I found in the water. Okay, now we are passing near one of the tidal channels. These are the little kind of pathways for the water to come in and go out of a beach. And you see it has a flow. Now the sun is that way. This is now the new moon time. So the sun and moon are in the same direction, so that's the high tide toward that. And now it's moving that way, so the low tide is coming toward us. So the gradually is water receding, going down toward the sea. Through these channels, the water flows toward the sea. And let me see if we can pass actually through it. It's not very deep. But you obviously can see there is a flow in toward the sea in these tidal channels. Now I'm on the other side of it. really beautiful. Move a little bit more toward the left. A little bit more toward the left. You're blocking the sun. Lovely. Oh, love. Go move a little bit toward the right. A little bit toward the right. 5 steps toward the right, please. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. Ah. That is beautiful footage. Why are you playing monkeys? One of the most beautiful parts of the Britain I've ever seen, this beach. It's beautiful. Such a calm day. This big seashell actually is part of this bivalve, which is connected to this smaller one. Beautiful. They're attached. That's the lower one and that's the upper one probably, most probably. And the seagull are visiting it recently. Okay, the sun is setting already, as said. But what I wanted to show is this. This is the boundary between this shelly part and the sand part. The sand part is hard, which is here. And the shelly part is soft. It's full of shells, it's covered. If you geologically consider this, it will be shell bed. When you come in future and you become rocks and everything, you will see rocks with full of shells. And they are really have been here for a long time. Even in this one, you see a lot of this barnacles are living there. It has been there for a long time, full of limpets in it. That's interesting. So when you walk on this, as you can see with the footprints, it's quite hollow, your foot sinks. Very interesting. I must say, in Britain, all the beaches I've seen, which I've seen quite a lot, this is one of the shelliest one. Full of shells everywhere. Usually people have overgrazed everything, they take everything out. Here you have a lot. I've been able to collect some good specimens. Like the ammonite beds in the lime ridges, where the shells were living and they're dying there, or they're coming here for whatever purpose, for reproduction purposes. This is a different one. And yeah, beautiful, nice place. And you can find even a big oyster like this, oyster shell. This is equal, as Susan told, to ammonite beds. we walk in, the crinkle. This is called Salmonite Beds and the Lyme Bridges.
The dead ones just get mixed up with the colours.
Yeah, they're brought here. The sea clowns. It can be a devil's toenail if it stays long enough to become fossilized. Similar to that, Riffia. It's bivalve anyway. Sun has set now in the Camber Sand Ridge. And that's the new moon. And planet Venus is beside it. At the center. That's planet Venus beside the moon. One of the most beautiful beaches in England, I've seen. Sandbars, these are like the sand dunes. They have been stabilized by this grass. Or you can stabilize the sand dunes using vegetation. As far as you can see, a sand dune here. And then the sea. If it was not because of these sandbars, the sea probably could come more inland. Experience. Sand dunes in Britain. I've seen a few movies, actually, a series that were filmed in this as if it's a kind of desert environment, which we're not. What happened? I'm here. I'm going the other way. No, no, you continue. That's the way. That's the way. Oh, look at this. That's the way. I'm going there, actually. That's nice. This is natural sand. What kind of sand it is? This has a lot of quartz in it. There's probably some chalk also outside. Interesting.